Hello there, boys and girls, Rich here. Today I am going to show you how to get a Clapton-esque, a Clapton-like tone out of an RP360 using the first preset, Plexi Drive. I am playing a Squier Jazzmaster, and this is what it sounds like on the bridge pickup. This is the guitar with no modifications to speak of, and no modifications here either. That's what it sounds like. And bear in mind, the Jazzmaster has a relatively hot output set of pickups in it because they're big-ass single coils. Hotter than a Strat? Yes. Hotter than a Telecaster? Debatable, at least on the bridge side, because the Telecaster rear pickup is overwound, at least on traditional models. So let's do some mods to this setting. But before we do, first we will take the guitar, go to the front pickup, which is the neck pickup to most of you, roll the tone, the volume is all the way up, roll the tone down to about half, so you get this. Sounds pretty good, but a little bit on the weak side. I mean, you don't want it too hot, but anyway. So to modify a setting on the RP360, you can do it with software, but I'm going to do it with just the pedal. This is the select knob. These are soft knobs. The function changes depending on what's shown here, so you'll see it at the bottom row. But anyway, you press this once, and we are now modifying the Plexi preset number one. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm actually going to enable the compressor. Now, this set preset already has a compressor on it, but it's disabled. So the way we get from left to right is we turn the select knob clockwise and counterclockwise. So I'm going to turn it clockwise once to highlight the compressor, CMP, as it is abbreviated. And you'll notice at the bottom left it says bypass, which means it's disabled. So we enable it by turning this knob, because it's the one directly under that portion of the screen. And now it says on, which means it is enabled. There are several different types of compressors in the RP360. The one that I want is the red one, which I believe emulates an MXR Dynacomp pedal. So I will turn this twice. This main squeeze, blue, which I believe, the blue compressor, I believe is an emulation of a Boss CS3, and the red one is a Dynacomp. And I leave the output at 99. Now you'll notice at the top right of the screen it says 1 of 2. Whenever you see that, that means you can press select again to go to 2 of 2, and I get extra settings, which on this one is just for sensitivity. There are different settings depending on what you're modifying. And to go back a page, press select again, so 1 of 2. Sometimes you will see 3 pages of settings. You can just keep hitting select until you get to the one you want. All I want to do is enable this and have an output of 99, which it already has. Now if I turn this off, bypass, we're sounding like this still. Okay, turn this on. MXR Dynacomp, the red compressor, is quite nice. So we'll leave that on. And now we will go to reverb. So I'm going to turn the select knob clockwise until, I might as well go through the other settings on this. Tube Screamer I leave as is. 68 Plexi with a 4x12 green back cabinet, leave as is. Silencer, oh yes, I leave that on, because if I turn it off, yeah, we get buzz. Single coil happens. Leave it on. EQ I leave as is. Now, oh, actually, see that one? This one has 4 pages of settings. I press select. I'm on page 2. Low, low, low. Mid, mid, mid. High, high, high. You get 3 knobs for each of the 3 bands. Crazy, but cool. Leave the volume as is. The chorus, I can turn that on, but I'm leaving it disabled because I want reverb. Tape delay, leave as is, which is off. Okay, now I'm on the reverb setting, which is off. Turn it on. I will change the model to Lexicon Room and change the level to 57. Oh, went out of focus. Sorry about that. Now it sounds like this. It's that nice little room. Now I could do the same thing with, let's see if I got it, Lexicon Studio. It's got a little bit of a shorter reverb on it. Set that one to 60. Actually, I like that one better. Now, if I go to the bridge pickup and I turn down the tone to nothing all the way, though, as Clapton called it, woman tone. Not too bad. Actually, I could stand to use a little more reverb there. Go all the way up to 70. Ah, a little too much. 65. Damn, it went out of focus again. Come on, focus. Oh, come on. Come on, focus. You know you want to. I apologize. There we go. Sorry. Oh, it's doing it again. What do I have to do to put you... Maybe if I put a water bottle in front of it. Hey, look at that. Magic! It does that again. I'm putting a water bottle in front of it. Jeez. So anyway, bridge pickup. Tone rolled all the way off. Compressor. Heavy reverb with short... What do you call that? Short reverb. Pretty cool, huh? And that's it. That's all you have to do. Now, in a live setting, you'd have the reverb turned off. But for a studio setting like this, this is actually pretty convincing. I dig it. I hope you dig it too. Is it? See ya.